Hello to one and all. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about short and miscellaneous sums of Spearman's ring correlation method. So as such, you can see illustration 24 in front of you. Let's have a look at it. A transport company wants to know the relation between driving experience and number of accidents by the drivers. The sum of square of difference in the ranks given to the driving experience and number of accident by 8 drivers is found to be 126. 8 drivers means n is equal to 8, and sum of square of difference in rank. Sum of square of difference in rank means sum of square of difference in rank. That is summation d square is found to be 126. So it is equal to 126. I hope you understood. Find rank correlation coefficient from the data. Now r is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. 1 minus 6 into summation d square. Summation d square is 126 upon n is 8 into 8 square 64 minus 1. And if you perform the calculations, you conclude at minus 0.5. I hope you understood this sentence. Sum of square of differences in rank. Sum, matlab summation, of square, matlab whole square, of differences in rank. Differences in rank means d. So whenever this kind of thing is given, it is nothing other than summation d square. Sum of square of difference in rank is equal to summation d square. I hope you understood this quite well. Illustration 25 in front of you children. Ten students selected from various schools of a district were ranked on the basis of their proficiency in sports and general knowledge. 10 students means n is equal to 10. The rank correlation coefficient obtained from the data was found to be 0.2. Later on, it was noticed that the difference in rank of two attributes or one student was taken as 3 instead of 2. Find the correct value of rank correlation coefficient. First and foremost, we'll just understand the parameters. 10 students means n equal to 10. The rank correlation coefficient was found to be 0.2. Now, this is nothing other than wrong R. This is nothing other than wrong R. All right. So, wrong R is equal to 0.2. Later on, it was noticed that the difference in ranks. Difference in ranks means D. Difference in rank means D. D was taken as 3 instead of 2. Was taken as 3, matlab wrong D is 3 instead of 2, matlab correct D is 2. So, four things, four parameters, first and foremost should be known well to you. You need to write down this in your notebook. 10 students means n equal to 10. Wrong R is equal to 0.2. Wrong D is equal to 3. Correct D is equal to 2. Correct R is equal to how much? Alright. Then, you need to do or solve the sums in 3 steps, dear children. All right. Always remember, whenever the information about wrong is given, and the same you have to find out in the correct form. At that point of time, 3 steps are necessary. Now, first step will be, please write it properly over here. It should be wrong R is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. Wrong R is equal to 1 minus 6 into wrong summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. Write wrong over here as well as wrong over here. So if you substitute the values, wrong R 0.2 is equal to 1 minus 6 into wrong summation d square will remain the way it is in the numerator upon n is 10 into 10 square 100 minus 1. If you go one step further, 0.2 will be the way it is equal to 1 minus 6 into wrong summation d square will be the way it is, and 10 into 99 will be 990. Now, dear children, this entire RHS, that is 6 wrong summation d square upon 990, will go on the LHS. So it will be 6 summation d square upon 990. It is in minus in the previous step. So if it goes on the LHS, it will be plus 6 summation d square upon 990. And if 0.2 goes from LHS to RHS, plus 0.2 will be minus 0.2. I hope this step is understood. Then after, dear children, 6 wrong summation d square upon 990 will be equal to 0.8. Now this 990 will get cross multiplied and 6 will get cross divided. So you will get wrong summation d square is equal to 0.8 into 990 upon 6. So wrong summation d square is equal to 132. Wrong summation d square is to be obtained in the first step. I hope no one will have any query in the first step. Just write down properly, dear children. Here you need to write down wrong r, and here you need to write down 6 into wrong summation d square. All right, I have sent solution of a similar kind of sum in exercise on our WhatsApp group. So you just can see over there the way I have did. Just do the sum in the same way. Now, if you get wrong summation d square, your second step is to obtain correct summation d square. So, correct summation d square is equal to wrong summation d square minus wrong d's whole square plus correct d's whole square. All right, as you are talking in square, so wrong d has to be squared as well as correct d has to be squared. Now, wrong summation d square in the previous step was 132. So, 132 minus wrong d is 3, 3 square. Plus correct d is 2, so 2 square is equal to 132 minus 9 plus 4 gives you 127. Your second step comes to an end. First step, wrong summation d square. Second step, correct summation d square. And the formula of correct summation d square is equal to wrong summation d square minus wrong d square plus correct d square. Once this is done, your final step is to find out correct r. All right. Correct r is equal to 1 minus 6 into correct summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. Here you need to write correct r, and here you need to write 6 into correct summation d square. 1 minus 6 into correct summation d square in the previous step was 127 upon n is 10 into 10 square minus 1 means 100 minus 1. And if you perform the calculation, you conclude the answer to 0.23. Once again, there will be 3 steps. First step, to be started with wrong r, and you can obtain wrong summation d square from the first step. Once the wrong summation d square is obtained, your second step is to obtain correct summation d square. And once the correct summation d square is obtained, your third step will be to obtain correct r. Hope this is understood. Three steps has to be remembered for such sums. Now, dear children, just see the 7th and 8th sum which you are supposed to do by yourself. I'll just give you a brief explanation of the same. 10 contestants are ranked in beauty contest by 2 judges, and sum of square of differences in the rank is 214. 10 contestants means n equal to 10, and sum of square of differences in rank, matlab summation d square, is equal to 214. Just substitute the value in our first basic formula, that is 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. You will get your answer. 8th sum, the coefficient of rank correlation of marks obtained by 10 students, n is equal to 10, in particular two subjects is 0.5. Wrong r is equal to 0.5. Later on, it was found that the difference of rank of student was 7 but taken as 3. Actually, it was 7, matlab correct d is 7, taken as 3, matlab wrong d is 3. Once again, 10 students, matlab n equal to 10, wrong r 0.5. Correct D 7, wrong D 3. And do the 3 steps, get your answer. Now, there are certain miscellaneous sums as well over here in this illustration. Now, check out illustration 32. To know the relation between the ability of, to know the relation between the ability in two different subjects for the student, a sample of 7 students, matlab n equal to 7, is taken from a score. From the information of marks in subject, in two subjects for 7 students, it is known that sum of square of difference in ranks of this mark is 25.5. n is equal to 7, and sum of square of difference in rank, as I told earlier, summation d square is 25.5. It is also known that 2 students got equal mark in one subject. Just make a underline over here. Two students got equal marks in one subject. Matlab, there is a tie in marks of two students. There is a tie in marks of two students means you need to perform a calculation of CF. All right, calculation of CF. Whenever there is a tie, correction factor has to be calculated. So two students means there is a tie in two observations. So M is equal to 2. All right. And the formula for finding out CF is equal to M cube minus M upon 12. 2 cube minus 2 upon 12 gives you 0.5. You already have N and summation D square with you. N was 7. 7 students and summation D square was 25.5. You got your CF from here. So replace the values in the second formula of Spearman's rank correlation method, that is R is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation D square plus CF upon N into N square minus 1. 1 minus 6 into 25.5 plus 0.5 upon 7 into 7 square 49 minus 1. If you perform the calculation further, you conclude it with 0.54 is your answer. This were three illustrations. There are certain similar sums in exercise which you are supposed to do by yourself. Solution is already sent on WhatsApp. 13 sum of section C, please. For 10 pairs, matlab n is equal to 10, summation d square is 120 and the value of rank correlation coefficient. Similar sum, just you have to replace the values in the first formula, that is R is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. N 10 and summation d square is 120. You can easily conclude this. There are two sums in section D. Just pay attention on the 12th and 13th sum. 12th sum first. The information obtained on the basis of rank given by two judges to 8 contestants. 8 contestant means n equal to 8 of dance competition is given below. The summation rx minus ry whole square is 126. Now rx minus ry, dear children, is D. Rx minus ry is D. So it is nothing other than D square. Summation D square. I hope this is understood. N is 8 and summation D square is 126. Where Rx and Ry are linked to the contestant, find Spearman's rank correlation method. Once again, as N and summation D square both are there with you, you have to just replace the values in first formula and get your answer. It is similar to previous. Now 13. Put a small tick mark on this sum number 13, dear children. The rank given by two experts on the basis of interview of 5 candidates for job are 3, 5, 5, 4, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1. Find the rank correlation coefficient. Now, my dear children, these are the rank given by two experts. So, the first one is Rx and second one is Ry. Ranks are given, so Rx and Ry. So, firstly, you are required to prepare a table in which first two columns should be Rx and Ry. Alright? So, in Rx, you will write 3, in Ry, you will write 5. Then, in Rx, you will write 5. In Ry, you will write 4. Then in Rx, you will write 1. In Ry, you will write 2. Then in Rx, you will write 2. In Ry, you will write 3. And then in Rx, you will write 4. In Ry, you will write 1. So once the Rx and Ry's column are ready, then you are supposed to prepare a column of D. D is equal to Rx minus Ry. And then you are supposed to prepare a column of D square. D square, matlab, D is whole square. Once the table is ready, you have to just replace the value in the formula, that is 1 minus 6 into d square upon n into n square minus 1. Check the solution that I have provided. Alright, mark this sum as a good sum. Section E was entirely concluded by us. In section F, there are certain short sums. Yes. Sum number 11th, please. A daily calorie intake of 10 persons, matlab n is 10, is x and their weight is y kg. A rank correlation coefficient is 0.6, matlab this is wrong R. Wrong R is 0.6. On subsequent verification, it was noticed that difference in rank of one pair was taken as 2 instead of 4. Wrong D is 2, correct D is 4. Taken as 2, matlab wrong, instead of 4, matlab correct. Alright, once again, n is equal to 10. Wrong R is equal to 0.6. Wrong D is equal to 2. Correct D is equal to 4, find the correct value of rank correlation coefficient. Correct value matlab it has to be obtained in 3 steps as we did it in previous 2 sums. Alright, I hope you will be able to do this. 12th sum, just put a small tick on this 12th sum as well, dear children. The information of health index X and life expectancy Y is obtained for 10 people. 10 will matlab N equal to 10. This data rank to find the rank correlation coefficient and sum of square of, just write over here, sum of square of differences of the ranks. Sum of square of differences of the ranks. Of differences of the rank is found to be 42.5. Sum of square of differences of the ranks means summation d square is 42.5. N is 10 and summation d square is 42.5. Now put a bracket over here. It was also observed that health index 70 was repeated 3 times and life expectancy 45 was repeated twice in the data, bracket close. It was observed that health index 70 was repeated 3 times. Repetition matlab tie, tie matlab ki CF. So you have to prepare calculation table for CF. In that observation 70 repeated times M, M is 3. In the same way observation 45 repeated times M, M is twice. Alright, that is 2. So if you calculate the correction factor, for 3 the correction factor is always 2. And for twice repetition, the correction factor will be 0.5. So total of correction factor will be 2.5. And just replace the values in the second formula, that is 1 minus 6 into bracket summation d square plus CF upon n into n square minus 1. And you will automatically get your concluded answer. Now, dear children, section B was left purposely by me entirely. So just have a look at section B. In all the chapters, we will do section B at the very conclusion of the chapter so that we don't miss any sum over here. Now, define correlation and define correlation coefficient. I've already made you write down the theory of the same. It was the very starting. Just pay attention on this question. Identify whether there is a positive correlation or negative correlation between the following pairs from question 3 to question 6. Now, before answering them, you need to know what is a positive correlation and what is a negative correlation. Dear children, we have also discussed this positive and negative correlation earlier. Positive correlation matlab if x increases, y increases, x decreases, y decreases. Matlab the change in variable x and variable y is in same direction. If x increase, y also increase. If x decrease, y also decrease. So positive correlation matlab changes in same direction. But on the contrary, if x increase, y decrease, or if y decrease, x increase, the change is in opposite direction. If the change is in opposite direction, it is a negative correlation. Alright, so just you need to know this. If the change is in same direction, positive correlation. If the change is in opposite direction, negative correlation. Now, from 3rd to 6th, we are supposed to answer this. The age of adult person and life insurance premium at the time of taking insurance under a plan. Now, my dear children, if the age of an adult person is low, the insurance premium is supposed to be low. But when the age increases, even your insurance premium increases. Matlab, lower the age, lower the premium. Higher the age, higher the premium. That means change is in same direction. If the change is in same direction, it will be a positive correlation. So, answer of third is positive correlation. Sales and profit, dear children. If sales increase, profit increase. If sales decrease, profit also decrease. Matlab, same direction. That means once again, it is a positive correlation. Rate of inflation and purchasing power. Now, just know this. If rate of inflation increases, purchasing power decreases. In the same way, if rate of inflation decreases, purchasing power increases. Alright, so there is a inverse relation. Matlab, the change is in opposite direction. If the change is in opposite direction, it will be a negative correlation. Altitude and amount of oxygen in the air. Lower will be the altitude, higher will be the amount of oxygen. But whenever you go on mountainous regions, your altitude increases. And if the altitude increases, your oxygen level drops. Alright, so there is once again a negative correlation in altitude and amount of oxygen. Hope this is understood. Seventh question, please. What can be said about correlation between annual import of crude oil and number of marriages during the same period? Annual import of crude oil and number of marriages will not have any correlation, dear children. You cannot say that because of increase in import of crude oil, the marriages will increase or likewise. All right. So there is a lack or absence of correlation. No correlation exists between them. You need to write lack of correlation. Eighth question, please. Now, this was one of the property that I made you thought earlier. Just we will refer the property first before moving on to question number 8. The property was R minus XY is equal to minus RXY. In the same way, RX minus Y is equal to minus RXY. And R minus X minus Y is equal to plus RXY. I hope you remember it, minus X and Y. So minus plus minus. Plus X minus Y plus minus minus. Minus X minus Y means plus XY. So now just go through the properties and answer this. The correlation coefficient between X and Y is 0.4. Matlab RXY is 0.4. What will be the value of correlation coefficient if Phi is added to X and 10 is subtracted from Y? Phi is added to X, matlab X plus Phi. And 10 is subtracted from Y, matlab Y minus 10. X plus Y, so X is positive. Y minus 10, Y is once again positive. So as X and Y both are positive, your answer will remain same, that is 0.4 itself. I hope this is understood. But if any of them would have been negative, your answer will be negative. If both of them will have been negative, your answer would once again be positive. All right. So your answer will be 0.4 itself. What is the main limitation of scatter diagram method? The main limitation is you cannot get an accurate values in this method. All right. This is just an estimate, not an accurate value. Put a small take on this tensor. If the value of n into n square minus 1 is 6 times the value of summation d square. So make a first equation. N into n square minus 1 is equal to 6 into summation d square. Just put the first equation over this. Alright, then what will be the value of R? Now, in the next step, you are supposed to write down the formula of R. R is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon n into n square minus 1. Now, R is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square will remain the way it is. But in denominator, n into n square minus 1 is there. However, n into n square minus 1 is 6 times summation d square. Matlab n into n square minus 1 should be replaced by 6 summation d square. So, you have to take a step like this, is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation d square upon 6 into summation d square. Alright, n into n square minus 1 is 6 into summation d square. And in bracket, you may write from 1, from equation 1. So, in the next step, it will be 1 minus 1 because 6 into summation d square in numerator as well as in denominator gets cancelled. So, 1 will remain. So, 1 minus 1, the answer will be concluded as 0. Please do this sum properly. And lastly, 11th sum, what will be the sign of R if the value of covariance is negative? There is only one formula with respect of covariance, and that is R is equal to COVXY upon SX into SY. COVXY upon SX into SY. Now, COVXY is in numerator. COVXY upon SX into SY means COVXY is in numerator. And if numerator is negative, the correlation coefficient, that is R, will also be negative. So you need to write it, sine of R will also be negative if covariance is negative. Sine of R is also negative if covariance is negative. So this is the end of chapter 2, correlation coefficient. I hope this chapter is well understood. Please keep on practicing, my dear children. And if at all you are having any query, any doubt, you're just a call away from me. See you once again with the next chapter, that is regression. Till then, take care. God bless you.